In this video, I will talk about an application of the newsvendor inventory model in overbooking for revenue management. Overbooking or overselling is sale of a good or service in excess of actual supply. It is a common practice in the airline, hotel, and rental car industries in which no shows or cancellations usually occur. Additional revenue can be obtained by doing a certain level of overbooking. Overbooking is allowed and regulated in many countries, and companies that do practice it are often required or forced by market competition to offer substantial compensation to customers who are denied due to excessive overbooking, even though they have a confirmed ticket. Some careful analysis must be done to achieve an appropriate trade-off between the additional revenue from overbooking and the risk of incurring these penalties. Let's see an example. An airline is creating the overbooking strategy for a one-way flight with I is equal to 100 seats. This is the inventory. The price of a flight ticket is $300. The tickets are non-refundable, so no shows forfeit the entire fare. Those customers who fail to check in on time are referred to as no-shows. It could be they are late, or their plans have changed. Based on historical data, the number of no-shows y is a random variable, and it follows a normal distribution with mean 8 and a standard deviation 3. So the average no-show rate is about 8% because the total capacity is 100 seats. If a customer is denied boarding, the cost to the airline is $800. The cost may include the fees for lodging and food before the customer can board a later flight, compensation for the inconvenience, and the cost of the loss of goodwill, or sometimes a refund of the ticket price plus penalty. The question is how much overboarding should be done so the airline's expected total revenue can be maximized, or the expected total cost can be minimized. We can convert this problem to a news vendor problem because it involves the overage cost and the underage cost. The news vendor problem has been introduced in a previous video. The unit overage cost CO is equal to P(9). If the number of no-shows or empty seats Y is less than the number of overbooked seats X, then the airline overbooked too many seats. X minus Y passengers will be bumped at the cost of P(9), which is $800. The unit underage cost CU is equal to P ticket. If the number of no-shows or empty seats Y is greater than the number of overbooked seats X, then the airline overbooked too few seats. Y minus X seats could have been sold at the price of P ticket. The goal of this problem is to find the optimal number of overbooked seats, X star, that minimizes the expected total overage and underage costs. In a previous video about the newsvendor model, we found out that the optimal quantity X star is determined so that the overage probability is equal to this ratio, the unit underage cost, over the sum of the unit overage and underage costs. Also, the underage probability is equal to this ratio, the unit overage cost over the sum of the unit overage and underage costs. The cost of denied boarding for each customer is $800, and the ticket price is $300 per seat. The unit overage cost CO is equal to the cost of denying boarding, $800. The unit underage cost CU is equal to the ticket price, $300 per seat. We can see that the overage penalty is greater than the underage penalty. Let's use this formula to calculate the overage probability. It is equal to 27.3%. We use this formula to calculate the underage probability. It is equal to 72.8%. The probability of overage is less than the probability of underage. The reasoning behind this is that because the overage cost or penalty is greater than the underage cost or penalty, we need to determine the overbooking quantity, X star, so that the airline will have a lower probability of overage than underage. Now the demand Y follows the normal distribution. This figure shows the probability density function of a general normal distribution with mean mu and standard deviation sigma. The overage probability is equal to the area represented by the shaded area. We can convert it to a standard normal cumulative distribution, and it is equal to phi x star minus mu over sigma. Here is the cumulative distribution function. We also know that the overage probability is equal to 27.2%, so we have this equation. Let's use the inverse standard normal cumulative distribution calculator to find the value of this item. The link to this online calculator is given below this video. In this box, type the probability value 0.273. It shows the inverse is equal to minus 0.604. Finally, the optimal overbooking quantity, X star, is equal to 6.2 seats. That means the airline may oversell 6 seats. This implies that the total number of tickets can be sold is the inventory I plus X star. This number is 106. We just saw the pure calculation in the most simplified case. What is happening in real world is much more complicated than this, and the revenue management team in a company has to handle many other factors before implementing the overbooking strategies. While we are on the subject, here are some interesting statistics about overbooking in the airline industry. According to a news article in PBS NewsHour, among the 3 major U.S. carriers, Delta, American, and United, Delta has the highest rate of voluntarily bumped passengers, 96 per 100,000 passengers. United has the highest rate of involuntarily bumped passengers, 11 per 100,000 passengers. What do the statistics mean to an average person? Let's do some simple calculation using my case. On average, I travel 2 times every year by air. If we consider the round trip, there will be a total of 4 flights for me each year. The life expectancy is 78.94 years for an average American. Let's round it up to 80 years. If I can live to the age of 80, I will be involved in 320 flights in my whole life. Let's use the worst-case scenario among the 3 airlines to calculate the probability of me being put on voluntary standby in my whole life. It is 320 times the voluntarily bumped passenger rate, 96 over 100,000. It is equal to 30.7%. This is a relatively moderate number, and it seems about right to me. I've never been put on a voluntary standby so far during my past 30-plus years. Let's use the worst-case scenario among the 3 airlines to calculate the probability of me experiencing involuntarily deboarding in my whole life. It is 320 times the involuntarily bumped passenger rate, 11 over 100,000. It is equal to 3.5%. This is a relatively small number. Now let's calculate the number of trips per year I have to guarantee so I will have a 100% probability of being involuntarily deboarded the whole life. Let's denote this number by n. The round trips will double the number of flights, times 80 years, and times the involuntarily bumped passenger rate, 11 over 100,000. We make it equal to 100%, and so for n. N is equal to 56.8 trips. It means I will travel by air 56.8 times per year, or 4.7 times per month, or 1.1 times per week, so I will get dragged off the plane once in my lifetime. I don't want to excessively interpret these results. These calculations are just for fun. Okay, that is the application of the news vendor inventory model in overbooking for revenue management. Thanks for watching.